When you come to Ghana now, you wouldn't hear Dumso. Because Dumso, Dumso was an issue to do with light off and on. When you come now, you'll still hear the doom, but not the so. You'll hear a phrase called Doom CC, that though the lights are going off, we are, in essence, providing the intervention to prevent it. Because energy remains a topical and an essential input in our collective efforts towards our economic recovery and our national development. It is so important and strongly linked to the development factors, including the SDGs for Agenda 2030. Energy is fundamental essence, is a fundamental essence in our national development, economic development. To accelerate economic growth now in COVID times, we need to start thinking differently and employing unconventional strategies and smart investments in our productive sectors of our economies. Failure to do so will hamper our economic and social growth and increase our vulnerabilities. Access to adequate, affordable, and reliable energy sources, like I said, is the fulcrum to economic transformation of the African continent and key to unlock our development potential. In order to achieve this, there ought to be increased investment to provide the requisite energy infrastructure, reliable availability, and services to the social and productive sectors. The upfront cost or capital investment for energy infrastructure, coupled with the limited access to funding, has inhibited the progressive development of these critical facilities. We therefore need to adopt a collaborative and innovative financing mechanism as a response to these challenges. That's why I come back to my brother. If now we in Africa are being told to move on the direction of our progress or economic development through clean, green energy, then those who are speaking like that should provide the needed capital and partnerships to make it possible. If we have coal in abundance in Africa, but we can't develop, use coal in our power sector, and we are being told to use clean, reliable energy, then those who have professed that should come to the table with the needed investment and partnership to let Africa develop in that direction. The continent is endowed with both conventional and renewable energy sources, which I believe, if properly harnessed, would help us to sustainably meet the energy demand and respond to the climate change agenda. My ministry is fully committed to the goal of developing and ensuring a highly reliable energy service at efficient cost to all sectors of the economy through the formulation, implementation, monitoring, and evaluation of energy sector policies. Recently, we amended our Renewable Energy Act with the sole aim of facilitating investment in our renewable energy sector to respond to emerging trends of the renewable energy market. Through that amendment, we empowered generators and manufacturers to ensure that renewable energy is part of the energy mix. The government's objective is to reach universal access by 2024. We in Ghana have an access rate of about 85%. But to reach universal access of by 2024 means that we have to move to 90%. And to achieve this, we want to even achieve this before our climate determined agenda of 10% renewable energy in our energy mix. And to achieve this, we are rolling out special programs, Scaling Up Renewable Energy Program, which is a multilaterally funded program with the Swiss government, Africa Development and Climate Investment Fund, and the government of Ghana. This is defining the renewable energy landscape in the country to allow private sector to participate and help us in our agenda of economic development. We are also working with the German government through its development agencies, the German Development Bank, to implement major, like the last speaker said, major works in the transmission and renewable energy generation projects across the country. I use this opportunity to thank the German government for making Ghana a part of its Marshall Plan for cooperation and economic development and their support for the ongoing energy sector recovery program. Whilst we make efforts to strengthen our existing power systems, we must also take note of the numerous advantages that the smart and green systems provide and ensure that they are incorporated accordingly into our systems. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I'm confident that we'll be able to foster workable collaborations in the areas of renewable energy, rural electrification, transmission and power distribution in a more green, affordable, sustainable manner towards socioeconomic improvement of our citizens. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister.